It's been such a huge part of my life ever since I was, you know, really young and starting out. And it was a place where people can come together from all over the world, from, you know, different like interests, and you know, there's a place for everybody on YouTube, which I'm a huge fan of. I've met so many of my friends here, and really it's just growing up on YouTube particularly has shaped me in a lot of ways and given me a lot of experiences that I don't think I would have had without it, you know. I'm very grateful. I feel like there's nothing quite out there like the YouTube community. You know, we're all so connected, especially in the UK. We know each other all so well, and it's like one big happy family. And it's been particularly crazy during this time of like my single coming out today and then coming here. I've just had like friends that I haven't seen ages like, well done, oh, thank you. And it's just so lovely and so supportive, and I feel like it's something that I'm gonna feel really, really lucky to have experienced, like when I get older, to be like, wow, being a part of such a big thing, and just coming here and getting to meet people. You know, you see people, you know, you see people's comments on tweet, and you don't make the connection. Like, you know they're real people, but you can't see them. And like, it's just this really crazy, like humbling, endearing feeling that I'm like, oh my God, like people actually like what I do, which, you know, it's kind of crazy. But yeah, it's so sweet. I love meeting everybody. And you know, it's like, I just get so emotional though. Like, I even like thinking about how much like I love meeting all the people that watch my videos is actually making me cry, like inside.
I'm glad you're holding it.
Yeah, I'm holding it together right now. You should have seen a video I posted today that nearly started crying in it from like, thank you for all the support on my single. So, yeah, anyway, sorry. The best thing on YouTube is there is no guidelines. Like, yes, you should upload 3 times a week because of the YouTube algorithm, but like, you can make whatever you want, you know. And like, what I find crazy these days is you can literally find everything on YouTube these days. You're like, oh, I wonder how I hit this nail into the wall in a specific way or whatever. I don't know, like my brother was talking about something to do with motorbikes the other day, and he was like, I'm gonna look on YouTube, and then he found it straight away. Crazy. I think that's a really, really amazing, exceptional thing that so many people have like created videos now to the point where it's like the internet is just filled with like so many different things on different topics. And I'm like, that is sick. You know, there's parts of YouTube that I probably don't even know about, you know, because they're not sections that I like brought into. But yeah, you do when you search for them, you know, when you search motorbikes, like my dad when he's trying to make Ducatis. Talking about YouTube, sorry. Talking about how YouTube is so wide and varied and you can find out whatever you want in a YouTube video tutorial. Like motorbikes and my dad and his Ducatis that he's trying to fix by hand. So yeah.
And on the other end of the...
Yeah.
What is the worst thing on YouTube? What is the most cringe thing you've seen on YouTube?
Pranks videos. Just all of them. Like, I'm sure that there's some good ones, but I haven't seen them yet. I just haven't. You know, someone like, you know, died the other week, right? From a prank video. Didn't the woman go to jail because she like shot her husband for a prank video? Yeah.
There was that.
Horrible. So sad. And like, you know, the ones that are just like funny are just not. So really excited for that phase to be over, if it ever is. My biggest hope for YouTube is that it'll give more newer creators a chance that put a lot of effort into their content and not clickbaity titles and etc. You know, like, I hope the algorithm changes for newer creators to give creatives more opportunities. I feel like that it could potentially sink their own ship, you know, if they don't help and support creators, like the new creators, because, you know, like, we have a lot of amazing creators now that do really well, but the next generation need a chance as well. And if not, then they'll go to like Vimeo or, you know, or whatever. Do you know what I mean? So that's something I hope, because yeah, I think it's important to give other people a chance. And it's hard because it's an oversaturated place now. But you know, I think it happens with every website, doesn't it? Right? You know, it's always the next thing. What was it before? Bebo, MySpace. Well, what are they? You know. Anyway, sorry, got really deep there, but it's so true. So all of you, I wrote it about 3 o'clock in the morning when I was having some problems musically. I was having a lot of conflict. I'd already started loads of songs that were like finished and produced, but for some reason they just didn't speak to me in the way that this song did at 3 o'clock in the morning on a keyboard. And I remember taking it over to my friend Ian, who I wrote with. He's the guy from Kids and Class Houses. And we wrote the song together and he was like, this is sick. And like, and then we did like the original demo and then we played it to people and they were like, this is crazy. And it was great to just go above people's expectations and my own expectations and write something that really I think can be enjoyed by a lot of people. I think it's a very easy song to listen to. It has a lot of relatable themes, you know, needing all of somebody. It's also quite a sexy song, and also at the same time it's kind of got that like intimate relationship connection. So it just has everything that I'd really want to portray in a song, and I'm very proud at the fact what we've been able to do with it. I mean, you know, I think it's good to be like empowering as, you know, a female. And something when we were creating the artwork for Leadley, you know, there was this whole thing of like, Bethan's gonna be like artistically naked in a tub because I'm covered in flowers. And there was a whole thing of like, how much skin can we actually show? And it's like, well, do you know what? If it's one thing I actually said, it was like, if it was a dude in the tub, would it have been any, like, what would people have even said anything? And I'm so glad we went through with it because everyone just, they totally get it. But there's this whole thing, you know, like when you go from something like YouTube where people like are like, you're child friendly, then when you go on and do something a little bit more just adult, you know, like as in like, I'm a 21-year-old woman, you know, people still see you as like that 16-year-old kid. And I felt like for us it was actually important to kind of make that statement and be like, no, I am an adult, and these are my songs that are very, very true and relatable to my own life, and I'm sure a lot of other adults as well. So no, I just want to keep making music that I'm proud of and get better and better. I feel like even though the single release is such a huge stepping stone for me and I'm very proud of what we've achieved, you know, I have bigger hopes for myself, and I only want to create, I only want to learn, and I only want to get better and create better things. So, yeah. The main reason I got involved with it is because, you know, when they brought it to me, I'd never heard of anything like this before, especially like on YouTube, on social media, a competition like this. And I was like, wow, this is so cool. And like, I get to bring it forward to like my own subscribers, and they have, you know, they get amazing opportunities, and they've done so many amazing things for me. And we got so many entries, like I was like, whoa. And you know, there's so many good songwriters in there. It was really, really hard to choose, but we ended up going for these four very creative individuals. They're all different styles. I honestly, I don't think I could really pick between them, like myself. So I'm glad that like there's a public vote to do it for me. I think you have to look at it objectively as well, because, you know, I like lots of, like, I like all kinds of music, you know. If a song is written well, then I'm gonna like it. So I felt like it could be very neutral in that way. Luckily, it wasn't just me. We also had a songwriting expert that had a degree in it, which was, you know, kind of helpful. And we just kind of went through all these like different things, and we were like, right, you know, like, is this okay? Like, is this okay? And then we kind of just like eventually, whoever kind of followed all of those the most, that's how we cut them down. And we were like, okay, this is fair. You know, everyone's had the same opportunities. Everyone knows what they were being marked on. And so, you know, yeah, I think it was a cool system. And luckily, it, you know, towards the end, once we got it down to like 10, you know, picking the final four, you know, it was like, okay, it was, yeah, it was good to get it down. I'm so glad that I don't have to pick from this point on, because it got really difficult after that point. And yeah, you get it down from hundreds of submissions to four, and you're like, how do you even pick from that point, you know? It's just, anyway. Oh my god, best bit of advice. At the end of the day, you know, I feel like being a, you know, like I said, it's when you want to do something that's creative, it can be, so there's so many off-putting things about being a creative and so many amazing things about being creative. Like, you might be a starving artist, you might have to starve for your art, and you might look at other people and be like, oh, they're better than me, but like, and it's going to sound so cliche, but there is only one you, and you have to stick with your gut, and you have to stick with what you believe in and your art. And that is the only way you will ever get to do what you do. You have to have faith in yourself, and you have to remember, like, heck, like, what I'm doing right now is pretty sick, you know? And if not, you'll get better, you know? You just have to keep sticking at it. And I believe that is so important, you know? It's no point, like, being sad over, like, how other people are doing. That shouldn't be a thing, you know? You should be like, wow, that person is so cool. I'm going to take inspiration for that, and I'm going to be cool too. Because you are. So, yeah. So I posted a video last week that I was actually really proud of, which was called What's It Like Being an Independent Musician? And I really like making those videos where I'm like, this is a really deep video, and then I like talk about my life, and then apparently it like inspires people, when really, like, behind the edit, I'm just like really insecure. But I get really, really proud of my covers. I did a Malibu cover that I'm very proud of. There's something that I really, really want to do actually more of is I did a kind of pilot episode of Music Honesty Hour with Bri a couple of months ago, which was an interviewing series based on actually interviewing artists about their music, and like specifically like, why did you pick this lyric, or why did you go in this musical direction? And for me, it was like something that I'd always really, really wanted to do, because I'm just so fascinated like by the actual creation of songs and the creation of like visuals and aesthetics and stuff like that, which is I want to do more of them. One day I'll get my foot out and carry on making them. I guess it would be really interesting if someone ever just like asked me like more about what my songs are about, because I always think that like people are gonna, and this is just music listening generally, you know, I guess if you have a particular interest in music, you focus on like all the aspects, you focus like on the lyrics and melody. But I guess if you're more of like a casual listener to music, you kind of just like go, this is a bop, like you like it or you don't. And so I think I'm always like, I guess I would like people to ask me more about like, why did I choose to do this, or why did I choose to do that in a song? But at the same time, it's like, if they like the song, I don't really care, you know? But I guess I expect people to be more nosy, and they're not. But I actually don't mind that. I don't mind people like asking me about my life, because if anything, like, I don't know, I think it's like kind of having the balls to ask is kind of like fair, you know? I guess that's what you got to do in your job, right? Yeah. There's a song called Inside Ahead, and it was like probably the most personal song I'd ever written, you know? Like, I had a really unfortunate like growing up experience. I had like an unfortunate like teen years with like family and stuff, and it was so, so personal, and I've never had anyone ask me about it, and I was like, that's crazy, because I thought it was so obvious. Like, I guess the story kind of speaks for itself, but it was a very, very personal song, and I was like, yeah, I let go more in that song than I probably have in my entire life and my entire writing career. So yeah, when you put yourself on the line and then someone's just like, nope, and then they just, yeah, that sucks, because you're already like in a weird place when you make that video, and then you're like, oh. But I'm quite fortunate, like I have a really good audience. I think it gets harder the more followings you get. Like, I'm lucky because I've spent 7 years on YouTube, and my following is like, in the grand scheme of things, quite small. And I look at it, and I just, the loveliest people have just stuck around. Like, I don't, but then there were points where I guess where I was like more relevant on YouTube back in 2012, and like I would get more hate comments. So it really depends how relevant you are, because there'll be people that are in there for the long run, you know, and they like you and they like your music and they're in for it. And then there'll be people that are like passing fans, which is totally okay, but they're more likely to like, you know, deliver a little horrible, because they don't know you the way that the fans that have been there for a while, or the fans that have really like connected with you in that way, you know. You're amazing, thank you so much. I'm sorry I don't post 3 times a week. And everybody, James in the back, wishes so I post on YouTube 3 times a week. No, I'm joking. Thank you so much. It means a lot, and I hope you enjoy the new single and the new music to come.